Dr. Purcell approached us probably about 2-3 years ago for help with this road traffic project. And at the time, it was something that was really, it connected with us because we're a city centre school. We've got a busy road at the front of the school. And so anything that we could do to help kind of, you know, help her research, which ultimately would go towards the goal of improving road safety, we were happy to do.
All the research I've done and others have done suggests that actually children are not as good at those kind of perceptual judgments at the roadside as adults. It became apparent to me that what we need to do really is think about whether or not children have a preference in terms of how they're learning about road safety. That actually children much prefer learning about road safety education if they're immersed in that environment. Now, clearly we can't take children to the roadside and experiment in safe road crossing, but we can do it in a virtual environment. We can do it in an environment where it's in a, you know, safe environment, but we're simulating roadside experiences.
What really interested me in it was the idea of having a real world problem that had a real world positive consequence, teaching children about road safety, and that would have technical challenges for us that would help us learn how we can use virtual reality in games, in education. We could use VR, but with kit that schools already had, and in a way that we could make it freely available to anyone. They wouldn't need to buy specialist kit. But I think early days are, we feel that it will certainly add something new that will be valuable because of that idea, that immersion, that idea of when I'm looking right, I actually have to look right and look left. And that kind of physicality, I think, has been missing.
The fact that she asked us to come and help, or she wanted the app developers to come and work with the children, was great on two fronts, really. One, we were pleased that the project was progressing. But on the other front, it meant that our children could be, on one hand, engaged in something that was a practical activity that was going to have some real benefit, and they could see the benefit of it. So that's great. It gives them a lovely feeling of confidence. Plus, they've got the skills that you can develop doing that. But from the other perspective, what they were doing by coming in, the app developers and the psychology students, were just showing our children some of the options that are available to them when they leave school.
I think one of the lovely things about this project, so the children are going to be at the centre of the design, they're going to be involved in the prototype stages of the design. The goal is that we will have an app that can be used within schools to supplement their existing road safety educational programme. And assuming that's the case, then we will aim to roll it out across all primary schools in Wales through a freely downloadable app.
Well, that's a nice car. What was that? It's really old, isn't it? That's impressive.